What's going on, guys? It's Mojo, and today we are doing yet another war recap for my clan Sanctioned here. This should be war recap number 6, I think. 6? I think I'm uploading 5 as I record this. So, let's get right into it. This is one, you know, a solid war. We did leave this one 94% 2-starred, which kind of sucked. And then I went for a 3-star on number 1 just because I knew we had the win anyway. So I did get the 1-star. And I'm going to go ahead and show you guys that raid real quick. It's one of the first times where my kill squad in a La Lune on a Town Hall 10 actually went like just as well or even better than I had planned. And then I actually messed this raid up by the air portion of the attack. So as you can see here, I'm just going to poison the clan castle troops. I did drop that goblin to check for a giant bomb because I know these trophy pushing bases often have those giant bombs just outside to trap those wall breakers. And so that goblin was there to check for that, but it was safe. I'm going to rage my kill squad here because I want to take out these two air defenses and basically a big portion of this southern teaser type portion of the base, I guess. And so the two air defenses and the archer queen are obviously the biggest priority. And I didn't mention this at the very beginning, but this is a stoned La Lune, so I have 3 golems, and then I also have the 3rd lava hound in my clan castle because I'm not sure how many air traps were going to be at the north part of this base. Here, I missed the free spell on that inferno, so that kind of hurt, but that wasn't actually what really did me in. What really hurt was just my balloon deployment and my rage deployment all together just kind of did not work. Also, these two balloons up here at the top, I don't know what happened exactly. There it is. The new hit point buff on all the archer towers means that 2 kamikazes and a bomb drop on a max archer tower won't take it out. So I didn't realize that one of my balloons got taken out by a seeking air mine, and that archer tower actually did a lot of damage to me. The other thing was just that the rage spells were nowhere near the inferno towers like they need to be. And then that free spell, since the raid was just running too thin already, I tried to go ahead and just expand that free spell all the way from archer tower to inferno tower. Didn't work out too well. You guys saw this raid in the 3-star in clan wars, the town hall 10 v town hall 10 hocus pocus. So I'm going to be showing you guys the classic holo Brad is bringing to this attack. So, we're gonna go ahead and fast forward through the balloon deployment. Just real quick, gonna grab a sip of coffee. Anytime you guys can cripple a base this much, take out that much point defense with only 100 camp space, that is huge. Like, this base is gone. These holo bases, real quick. So the poison spell here, we're gonna pause it. The poison spell is not used perfectly, but it did take out the witch, which is the biggest threat. So, you know, that's okay, but could have possibly been better. But anyway, the other thing you may notice is that Brad has already used all of his wizards, so he has no cleanup troops, but also he has no king, so this is... Anytime you can pick a base, it's going to be this easy to like holo or any Valk based attack. That's a great attack to use without a king, because holo raids are just super easy. You cripple the base very heavily before even going in, and then the Valk based raids, those Valks can often almost substitute your king. And as you saw in my live attack a few videos ago with the Valo. So anyway, Brad's hogs are standing in heels like this entire time. I think he loses 3 hogs total. 2 on the way into the Expo and Teslas, and then 1 by that giant bomb. But they're standing in heels while they take on this king, and then they're at full health when they just nick that last giant bomb, so none died there. And as you can see, this base is gone, but like I said, he didn't have any wizards for cleanup, so he is going to run tight on time, but that's going to be the end of the raid. So 3 stars for Sanctioned, and we are moving on to the next attack. We've got Myself coming in on number six. It's not a tough base, but as I was just talking about the Valks, we're bringing in some twirly girls on number six. So this is a pretty common internet base, and the twirly girls are just great for ripping it apart. Because look at those air defenses all up at the top. The Archer Queen is still accessible from the core to take her out with the Valks. But anyway, at the very beginning here, if you'd missed it because I was talking, I dropped a giant and three hogs on that cannon because I'm gonna do a shattered entry here, and I didn't want my golems to clump up on that cannon. So anytime there are external defenses, make sure you guys are really worrying about those so that your golems don't clump up, because I wanted to make sure that my funnel was super wide so these Valks went into the core. So that started the raid. Then I'm gonna drop my golems here. I drop also this is just a really small little nuance. I dropped my level 4 golem on the right side because I saw my hogs were either gonna at least either take out that archer tower right here, or they were at least gonna tank for it for a couple more seconds. So I put my lower level golem on that side just to try to keep the health of my golems kind of even. So here I'm just making my funnel with the wizards. Drop the jump spell. The golems redirect into the mortar and the other two compartments. And then in come the Valks. I did drop my king even after my Valks, which was probably a mistake, but it wasn't too big of a deal because my golems were already pretty out in front, and I had a rage and two heals just for my Valks. On a Gova Ho, where you have the hogs, you usually need at least one of your spells for your hogs. So you have to be a little bit more patient with your Valks and your Barbarian King just so that you get a lot of value out of those guys. But in the Gova Lo, where all your spells can go towards the core, you can kind of you have a little more leeway, I guess, is what I'm trying to say here. T-Smith needs some giants. While this is cleaning up, you guys can see that I'm just collapsing on this base. I'm gonna switch accounts on my phone and get T-Smith some giants while this is just cleaning up here. I did save one balloon in the bag because I noticed all these defenses were history, and this Dark Elixir storage was gonna have a pretty tough time going through. So, Twirly Girls bringing home the 3-star. Most of them lived through the raid, which is awesome. Anytime you just have a lot of Twirly Girls on cleanup duty is a great sight to see. So, moving on to the last raid of the video, we've got my little baby account taking on a Town Hall 9. So obviously it's a rush Town Hall 9, but oh no, I gotta train up some giants. I thought I had some trained already. But anyway, this is a rush Town Hall 9, and the Clan Castle is super easy to lure, but it does have Expos, it has all the new traps, and it has the Archer Queen. So, it's not a joke of a base, especially for a Town Hall 8 that doesn't have all the max troops and max Barbarian King. But anyway, there is a Witch and a Valk in the Clan Castle, and I knew that because this was a cleanup from our other Town Hall 8 that gave it a try. So I brought two minions. I brought a barb to aggro that Valk, and then the minion's just gonna finish it off, and I poisoned the witch. So I got a lot of use out of that poison spell, and really efficiently dealing with that Clan Castle, only using like 6 or 8 troop space. But anyway, here we go. I've got a Max Pekka in my Clan Castle, and everyone's reaction when I requested for a Max Pekka, when they saw my request said Max Pekka baby, everyone just started like, uh-oh, what is this guy gonna even try to do? But as you can see here, my plan here is to try to funnel. It was really hard to make my funnel because the archer towers were very easy to just pick off, or were very positioned well to where they could pick off my funneling wizards. So I had to get a little bit lucky for my Pekka to target the Archer Queen. I'm breaking into this wall, and here we go. Here comes the Pekka, and right before it goes down, big old one shot on the Archer Queen. And now I'm just going to two finger drop these hogs, try to get them in real quick. And like I said, since this is a cleanup attack, I do know where the giant bombs are. So other than that first heal, I'm going to be able to deal with all the giant bombs pretty well. Which one of them was here. So I pre-healed that. And then one of them was up on the northeast part, and I pre-healed that. And then the last one was right here by the air defense and dark elixir drill. But obviously, if you guys are, you know, anywhere near familiar with hogs, they aren't going to path from air defense to dark elixir drill, because a dark elixir drill isn't a defense. So I didn't have to worry about that one, thankfully. Sadly, I only had one cleanup wizard because the funnel was super hard to make. But placed him pretty well. Maybe could have put him down on this gold storage instead, and he would still end up taking the walk around the south end of the base. But no worries. My barbs and that one hog got a little bit of a lucky split, and we are going to take home the Town Hall 8 v Town Hall 9 3 star. So pretty solid deal there. Let me go ahead and donate some of these giants to T. Smith. If you guys don't know T. Smith from One Hive, you are missing out big time. Go to Jake from One Hive's channel. I'll probably put a link in the description. If you, for some reason, are not subscribed there, you need to be if you have any interest in war at all. And T. Smith is like one of their top tier attackers at One Hive. So fantastic clan there, and fantastic YouTuber for sure. But anyway, that is going to be it, guys. So we did do pretty well that war. Next war recap that I'm about to record was a little sloppy, but a lot of it was due to the interface changes on the new update, just kind of glitching and effing us up a lot. But that is going to be it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the Town Hall 8 v Town Hall 9 3 star. If you learned anything from here today, make sure you share this with your clan mates. You know, get them 3 starring in Clan Wars as well. Anyway, thanks again for watching. Hope you guys have a great day, and peace out.